Hello and welcome back to Hand Sewing with the HTA. In this episode we're going to show you how to do the lapel hole. So I've just used the same piece of cloth I used for the last hole, and I've already marked the length of it at 7/8 and came in 3/4 from the end, and I've machined either side of the chalk line. So it's all set up just like we did with the previous hole. So I'm going to make up some gimp for it. This time I'm going to use a green coloured silk. I've used it for the gimp. This actually is one hole where you could get away with using the gimp, pre-made gimp, because it doesn't get used. So there's not a little chance of wear on it. So if you want to save yourself some time, you had some of that, by all means use it in your lapel hole. I'm going to start off by waxing up the silk as we did in the previous video. Want to get lots of wax on there, want to get really well coated. And then start the other way as well. Now we take the through threads, put them together. And then put another bit of wax on it. Fold it again half through the needle. And then get it in there. Start twisting it up. Nice and tightly, you see it's starting to buckle like that. And then just get a piece of scrap lining and just get rid of the excess wax. Take it and put a knot in it. Now I'm going to take my red silk, give it a stretch length of the arm, give it a stretch, give it a pluck, and then wax it up. Leftover waistcoat back here and use it to sandwich the silk between the two layers so it can melt the wax off it. Melt the wax into it, really. Now, do that. Take my size 9. Trying to thread my thimble there for a second. It's a cold day here, my hands are shrinking. And yeah, thimble keeps popping off on me. As it gets colder, your hands tend to shrink. The thimble doesn't fit it quite as well. Now, so there's two ways you can do this, and it really depends on your punch. You can punch it with the smallest hole, or you can just cut it. I tend to punch mine. So let's put the card behind it, get the clean cut, and then line it up right in the middle of the X, and punch it. Now this will get you a hole then to put the tip of the shear through. Length of the lapel hole. Now, let's take our gimp needle. I'm going to say this is the inside, so about a half inch down from the end of the buttonhole, and feed the needle under the top layer of cloth. Place and then pop our needle in again under the top layer of cloth, feeding it into the end of the buttonhole. So let's start stitching up the buttonhole now. I got the switch knee thimbles. Switch to a smaller one. Hopefully it'll stay on my finger. Got the stitch length set and now the gimp in position. Just keep drawing it off at a 45 degree angle. Looking pretty good. And I'm going around the top of it here. I want to get just a nice little spread on it. And it's back into a straight stitch down the other side of the side of the hole. We're back into the last stretch here. We've got to successfully navigate the top of there. And we're coming back down the opposite side. Again, there's always a kind of help it, but there's always the tend to always, what am I trying to say? You tend to space them out more. So you want to try and close that spacing as you're coming down. You run out of thread, so we tend to space the stitches out a little bit more further apart. So just to be aware of that, try and keep the stitches close together. Because you're running out of thread and you're worried you're going to run out for the end, but we've got plenty there. And just have to try and keep the stitches consistent. And then we take the needle, press it back, push it back out to where we came in. Taking the gimp with it, of course. And just put in our last few stitches. Now we can do our bar tie. Turn it this way. push it through back out to where I came in. Then come inside here and get it, pull the threads and sort of pull the stitches closer together and push it up. Cut it off. That's our lapel hole. So probably they made these stitches here just a little bit too long. If they had them a wee bit shorter, it would have been a bit nicer. But well, no, it's not a bad hole. It is. Obviously, anytime you do anything contrasting thread, every little thing's gonna scream at you. But stitches are fairly consistent down both sides. Just went a little bit off in these top, and these stitches probably just that little bit too long on it. All in all, it's not a bad hole and it's certainly functional. So that's all we have time for in this lesson. Thank you for watching.